Hello guys, this video I will try to introduce to you guys about customized model in Sylius. So let's get started. Okay, how do we customize a model? First, for example, now I will add a new field for the table Sylius country. Now it has three column, right? Add one more field. We can run this command to know where the country last where is it, and here you can see the parameter will be always started with Sylius, and the second one is the model and the country and last. So we need to add a model to it, right? So we need to extend this last. So let's do it. We go to our appender, right? Okay, right here we create a new directory. Perfect. Now create a last. We call it a country. Yes. Okay, just create this last. And second one, we will try to add an entity mapping. It will be inside the resource config, and we will create a new directory and a new file. Okay, here very logic, we define the new entity last, right? Which and the type in the table, the same right here, a new last and the type and null able, right? Now we need to go to the config, and we will override the model last. We go here, app config and go to the Sylius addressing. Right, there are no one. Okay, in case we define Sylius addressing, why is addressing? Look at here, we try to this, let's open this last. You see, it become to the component Sylius component addressing here. It belong to component addressing, so we should but here in the config file will be Sylius addressing. Now we need to update the database, so we can go to the command line and run. Okay, first one we will try to run this command doctree either package management and very famous or ORM in the speaky words. So schema is about the database we are an update. We try to show the actually it will run in this update, and you see it will try to enter the country and add the last file. Okay, look perfect. Now we can run this by this command, and okay, we can try to test it out by right. See, we have a new field, very flexible. So what happened? We over the model. The first, the parameter Sylius model and country last content will bond to this directory, bond to our new model here. When we bond the Sylius dot model, some kind like. Is this one Sylius will bond to that directory, and under Sylius repository country regression doctree repository for your new last, and also Sylius manager country regression doctree on your for new last controller also new, and of course on doctree relation to Sylius component address model vendor are using our new last air target entity. So we do not need to do any further. So that's it, that is one how we can customize a translatable model. So one of translatable entity is shipment method. So we will try to find that shipment here. When shipment here, and you will see the shipment method and a shipment translation here, and we, it will a translatable ID, right? And the name and the locale. Okay. For example, we have delivery methods have many different delivery time. So we will try to add one more field estimated delivery time. So just like before, we already run some kind of here we go. We will try into will extend this model. Right. Okay, go to our entity and create a new file. Okay, here I already implement this last. It will extend from the base last, and it will try to match this some kind of try to create the translation, and it will be some kind of create a translation. We must implement it. Next, just like before, we will try to create an ORM. So create this. Okay, perfect. Now we need to just like before, right? And the field is in the field name, a new field name in the shipment method, and we need to go to the config here, and we will try to, as you know, how we can define the bundle, right? Let's like we go to the shipment method again. Yeah, find this one. It belong to call mode bundle. But you can see the shipping method ORM will belong to the shipping bundle. So just go to the config and we put shipping. It will be a shipping bundle, not about core. Okay, and result country, right? No, shipping method, and the last will be shipping method. Okay, now go to the control and run this command again. Set line directory and dump at well first. The property estimated delivery time do not exist in the shipping methods. Perfect, let's check it out. Yeah, sorry, I made one mistake here. What I need to do is very simple. Just right click here and generate, and it's gonna done. Okay, try run again. Okay, perfect. See, it will try to add a new record. Okay, now we will how to customize a strength label field of a strength label model. So support, we want to add a strength label property to a strength label entity. For example, a shipping method. So we add a new field called delivery condition. So let's do it. Okay, we remember this lab because it's shipping mode translation, right? We create a new entity. translation. Okay. Okay, and just like you, not using. Translation. Okay, and last seven methods. Translation is then base seven methods. Translation. Okay, next we will go to the RM, of course, and read the one. Just copy this for faster. Shipping methods. Okay. Okay. Okay, perfect. We delivery condition. We have an us here. Sorry, guy. Okay. Okay. Now go to the shipping methods. We need a new field. And we need to define a constructor. Okay, perfect. Now we already and configure the last here using the by shipping methods. Also, we provide the access to the new view in the shipping methods and initial the translation collection in the constructor here. And we use the new style. So we also define a set delivery condition and also get delivery condition. So now what left is we need to go to the Sylius shipping and we define the last and also the translation. Okay, perfect. Now we test. Maybe it work or not. Just trying to run the command. Okay, and that's it. We have done. We are already successful adding a new field for the entity strength label. Just run it. Okay, and check again. And that's it. Thank you for your watching.